What if a television show could be a video game, and a video game could be a television show? That's the GUI center of Quantum Break, a new game from Remedy that is being published by Microsoft Studios for the Xbox One. We actually can't show you a lot of Quantum Break because most of it is behind closed doors, but we do know a lot of what it might look like, and that is by looking at Remedy's previous games, Alan Wake and Max Payne 1 and 2. Max Payne was the big action series in which the character who had lost his wife and child had the ability to kind of slow down time in his mind and shoot people in the face. And then Alan Wake was sort of the opposite, where you're an average writer who's fighting his inner demons. It was like an episodic television show. You smash those two together and you get an idea of what Quantum Break is. It's this episodic gameplay experience akin to television with much bigger action. The game circles around this university town in which a time-traveling experiment gone wrong has given a few people, the people you play as, the power to manipulate time.
Time is your power. You can do things with time, and that's your strength. But at the same time, time is breaking down, and it is an obstacle, and a hazard, and a danger in the world. So there is this shifting balance that you take advantage of time, and you can do all kinds of things with that. At the same time, we have these localized time anomalies in the game where time breaks down or freezes or skips forward and backward. And you know, we've shown the glimpse of that scene where a huge cargo ship crashes into the bridge. And so the ship is whisked forward in time, and even though the bridge is lifting out of the way, there is no time because suddenly the ship is there and it crashes.
From the very little we've seen, the game has that kind of quiet sensibility of Alan Wake during certain scenes, where we're exploring the characters on an intimate level. In other scenes, there is obviously explosions and shooting and violence and ships crashing into highways. There's kind of this dichotomy, right, between the Alan Wake sensibility of a more quiet action game and the Max Payne sensibility of all hell will come to those who get in front of me. How those two will actually play nicely together, we'll have to find out. The big surprise, the thing that makes this one of the most ambitious projects happening at E3, is that there's a television show included with the game. A full season of television show with real-world actors filmed on real-world sets.
To me, it's kind of a natural thing looking at past games already, that we have been using live action more and more as part of these experiences.
Kind of if you look at the Max Payne games, Max Payne 1 and Max Payne 2, like when Sam wrote the story for those, he used the structure of a movie. And what Sam was thinking after Max 2 is that there must be a better way of telling a good story in video games. And then, you know, these great HBO modern day TV shows started to come out, like Lost and so forth, and we're like, wow, this is great. This looks like a really good structure for a video game as well.
To me, it's kind of a natural thing looking at past games already, that we have been using live action more and more as part of these experiences. In American Nightmare, we were exploring using live action in cutscenes as well. We are not doing that with Quantum Break, but it was an interesting experiment.
We've seen similar things to this, like Defiance, that Trion Worlds MMO that had a sister television show on Sci-Fi. But that was an MMO, and they had a bit of time to kind of alter the game and include it by running it, you know, days or months later. This television show will actually be included on disc, so how it evolves with what you do seems crazy? Stupid? $1 billion idea that will make Xbox a lot of money? I don't know, but we'll find out in a year or so when it actually gets made. The real challenge I think the studio faces is creating a piece of content that is on par with the amazing television that's going on now. Traditional writer's room can have anywhere from 5 to 20 some writers. The writer's room now has 4 at Remedy, which is very small for a television show, let alone for a television show that's included in a video game that interact with each other.
Creating a AAA game, and not only a AAA game, but also you know, a high quality live action show component, it's a huge undertaking. And fortunately, when we went and pitched this crazy idea and said, this is what we want to do, we want to do the ultimate Remedy experience, this, you know, this component and this component, it's a game, it's a show, and they reflect each other, and this is the experience we want to create. And having Microsoft say to us that, listen, this is actually what we're setting out to do with our next generation, with Xbox One, to fuse a little bit of television and gaming as well, this is a perfect concept. So yeah, it does feel like a natural fit.
From the get-go, the ambition is high and we are building something big, and I'm already looking beyond kind of the first season of Quantum Break. But you know, we are still making this first one. Let's see what happens.
It feels like a real play for a much larger mainstream audience, the people who maybe haven't played an action shooter or a video game ever before. And I think that's kind of the intention of the Xbox One in general, right? Microsoft wants this one device. It's going to be your TV, it's going to be your Netflix, it's going to be your video games. And here is a game that kind of encapsulates all those things. It's on-demand television mixed with a video game, and it's pulling in as many people as possible. So it's a gamble, but if it works, if it pays off, it could be bringing people to video games that were never there to begin with.